Once again, I am Dr. Jose Oclaret of the Matias H. Aznar Memorial College of Medicine, Department of Biochemistry. Now, I would like to make another footnotes about my doubts. I would like to express to you and explain to you my doubts and apprehensions about the RT-PCR results. It's like this. In my experience of PCR analysis, one time when I had my postdoctoral fellowship in Japan, the Agency of Science and Technology of Japan, I have to establish the identity of about 20 species of microorganisms that I have isolated from marine sponges, which are antibiotic producing. Now, since some of these microorganisms have similar biochemical characteristics, you have to narrow down the identification of these microorganisms using what you call the PCR analysis. In order to do that, that means I have to establish first the universal primer for identifying the ribosomal DNA, because the actual signature of microorganisms actually is in the ribosomal DNA. Now, ribosomal DNA are those segments of the DNA that codes for the ribosomal proteins. And so therefore, in order to differentiate one organism from the other, you have to sequence the ribosomal DNA of each organism. In order to do that, you have to make a universal primer for all the microorganisms, say gram-positive or gram-negative bacteria. So you have to have a universal primer for all the gram-positive bacteria. And using this universal primer, you can then extract the specific rDNA sequence of each microorganisms in order to differentiate one organism from the other. In other words, you cannot make a PCR as a tool for identification unless you have already established the universal primer. Now, in this case, since the COVID virus has about 5,000 strains that have been mutating, you have first to sequence the 5,000 mutated strains and look using a bioinformatics tool. You can now identify of these 5,000 mutated strains, you can now identify the segment of primers which are universal for all the 5,000. In other words, you cannot make a PCR primer unless you have sequenced all of them, because the rule in PCR analysis is that you cannot make a primer unless you have sequenced the whole genome. In other words, and whoever did that, nobody did, di ba? So in other words, this 5,000 mutated COVID virus cannot be identified using the PCR unless there is a consensus sequence for all the 5,000 mutated viruses. So, therefore, since it was not done like that, therefore, if they are using a particular primer for coronavirus, because COVID is a coronavirus family, then including those species or strains that are not COVID are then reckoned positive because of the consensus sequence, or what you call the conserved regions. Therefore, that is now actually the flaw of the experiment. That's why Dr. Mulis was surprised about using the PCR as diagnostic, when in truth and in fact, PCR is only for magnification of a certain segment of a DNA or RNA, which is actually identified by the universal primer. So therefore, since the universal primers for all these 5,000 have not yet been identified, therefore, you cannot make use an RT-PCR as the gold standard diagnostic for pinning down whether it is COVID-19 or not, because as you know, even COVID-19 is actually coming from SARS-CoV-2. In other words, SARS-CoV-2 and COVID-19 have a consensus sequence whereby they can be identified as a coronavirus. And the best technique is like this. When you have already had the sequence, therefore, you are going to compare the total sequence of the whole genome, differentiating one strain from the other. I have already, in my experience, I have submitted at least 10 ribosomal RNA sequence to identify all those microorganisms that I have. So after I have sequenced I have magnified the rDNA sequence, it was then referred to the Universal Gene Bank and tried to find out whether that sequence existed as an organism or not. If not, then you have to assign a specific name for that. So in other words, since this is not yet done, therefore, at this point in time, the RT-PCR is really doubtful because they have not yet established the consensus sequence of the 5,000 mutated strains. As I say, I repeat, you cannot make use an RT-PCR to diagnose whether it is a COVID-19 or not unless the whole genome had already been sequenced universally. So in other words, my dear fellow in the academe, please think it over. It is not therefore reliable to depend on the RT-PCR unless the universal primer had already been identified for all these 5,000 strains. Thank you very much and good evening.